Hey friends, if you want the best performance and availability for your mission-critical workloads, the Business Critical Service Tier for Azure Database for MySQL Flexible Server offers superior performance, enhanced security, and robust failover capabilities. Sid Sawant is here to show me the latest advancements today on Azure Friday. Hey friends, I'm Scott Hanselman and it's Azure Friday. I'm here with Sid. How are you, sir?
Thanks, Scott. It's great to be here, and I'm doing very well.
I'm glad to be chatting with you. You know, I've done a lot of MySQL, and I understand that this new business critical service tier is super interesting, and you've got a lot to share today.
Yes, I do. We will deep dive into business critical tier and how does it give you better performance and why was it relaunched into business critical tier.
So I understand that in build 2022, there was a thing called the memory optimized tier, and there's these different tiers available for people who want to use MySQL, but there were some introductions that were made during build and since then, is that right?
Yes. We launched business critical tier back in build 2022, which was previously known as the memory optimized tier. So we had this, we launched this as a business critical because the business critical tier not only gives you scalability options, like, you know, you, in scalability options, you get higher memory compute. So currently we have around 96 vCores of memory available, the vCores available, and then we have 672 GB of memory available. So for the customers who want to scale up to that level, if your business is growing and you have, you need a higher vCores, you definitely have that kind of support from the hardware. You also get storage support of up to 32 TB, and it keeps on growing day by day, right? And as the business keeps growing, we also have to support higher storages, higher memory, and that's the scalability options. But we have made this business critical tier very categorically for the business or tier one or mission critical workloads. So we have to give them something better, not just higher hardware. You need better performance, right? And better performance requires higher throughput, lower latencies. And that is basically possible because of a feature called as accelerated locks. So we recently had a GA of this feature in build 2024, but we also have another feature which helps the performance of the business critical tier, which is an auto scale of IOPS. Auto scale of IOPS and accelerated locks, this combination makes you makes the business critical tier really high performant, you know, and scalable option are already there. But you also get this high performance. We'll talk about these two options, but we'll go in deep in the demo in later on about the accelerated logs. But I'll quickly walk through about the auto scale IOPS, if that is okay.
Yeah, absolutely. Because I understand that the combination of the auto scale of the IOPS, that input output, those operations, plus the lower latency, just it all adds up to performance. It's like double the performance that people are expecting to get. So I'm excited to hear about
exactly.
that.
Exactly, you're right on. So it, with auto scale IOPS, what you get is the IO strategy is auto scale. And with the limit of 80K of IOPS available, the users can scale on demand. So there's no need to pre-provision your IOPS. You don't have to worry about what is my workload like, what I don't need to do any benchmarking. You don't have to worry about, you know, will my storage be a throttling factor for me? Will it be problematic when I run my businesses? So if you have variable workload, you have, you know, there are some, it's for example, in your, if you have some selling, if you say this, there is a, for example, if you have a gaming workload, if you have a gaming workload, in that workloads, usually you require high throughput sometimes, and you know you it's a variable workload when the users log in and you know log out. So it depends on the time zone. So auto scale of IOPS really helps you there. So you don't have to worry about provisioning your storage of IOPS. So in it scales up to 80K and whenever you need. And the best part of it is that it gives you the option of pay as you go. So you only pay for what you use. So that is the best part. That you know, if you have the ability to scale to higher limits, but it does not really charge you. We do not really charge you for your limits, but we only charge you for what you use. So that is the best part, I believe, in auto-scale IOPS.
All right. Well, I think the best way to understand this is to see it.
Yep. We'll be talking about accelerated logs in this demo. The accelerated logs is a different feature, which is the business critical feature for gaining higher performance. In this, I am showing you the demo where this is a recorded demo because it has a lot of pieces together to fit in. There's a Sysbens test. So that's why we have a recorded demo. Here on my screen, you can see I have a business critical server with 32V core, which has a 256 GB of RAM. And I will go and enable the accelerated logs later on. But now we are doing a Sysbens test where I have 128 threads running parallelly and on a 20 tables, which has 20 million rows for the time of 300 seconds or so. So I run this Sysbens on my test servers and I've just fast forwarded it so that you get so you don't waste time on waiting on this one. So the Sysbens is running and you can see this is business critical performance out of the box for a 32V core server.
Wow. Okay. Yeah. I'm looking at that. I was going to say the queries per second, 90,000 plus queries per second. That's exactly. Fantastic. And the latency is quite low.
Yeah. The latency is around 51 milliseconds. This is an out-of-box performance for business critical tier currently, if you're not enabled accelerated logs.
Yeah. So now let's go in. One millisecond. It's actually on the high end. The average latency was even lower there.
So yeah, let's go to the compute and storage section under settings. Here is where all the magic happens. You can change your IOPS settings. You can change your storage. You just have to enable, click on this checkbox and save. And you are ready to use the feature. But yeah, it requires a restart. So you have to plan your maintenances accordingly.
And that accelerated logs feature is that recent feature for users of the business critical service tier that optimizes all those transactional log related operations. And that gives you a real serious performance boost.
Yes. Yeah, we've been RDBMS, as you know, transactional logs are quite important and it helps the latencies. And that is why we've taken these logs and put them on faster storage. Mm-hmm. And that really helps us to gain that performance boost in the Azure environment. So now, as you see, we have enabled accelerated logs. We'll run the Sysbens test again with the same settings where we have 128 threads, 20 tables, 20 million rows on and for 5 minutes or so.
All right, here we go.
All right. Yes. You can see already the TPS increasing from 4.5K, I think.
Can
see the queries. Queries per second, QPS increasing to 190K, and the transactions per second is around 9,500. I think the latencies have dropped to 21 or 22 milliseconds, you can see. That's the right comparison here. You can see that the latencies were around 51 milliseconds, which has dropped down to 21 milliseconds, 22 milliseconds. And the performance gain, so the QPS gain, or throughput gain, as you can say, is 190K. So which is around 2x increase in the QPS, right? So these are the different threads where we try to do comparison on different queries per second. The parallel queries which we run in MySQL is 16, 32, 64, 128, 256. And these are the gains which we have with all the thread options. And as you can see, the latency has dropped and the QPS has increased variably.
Yeah, those latency numbers and that throughput, that's where you get your 2x. I mean, you went from, you went down to 21 milliseconds. You cut it in half on the latency side, almost doubled it on the throughput side. That it seems like that that additional improvement, not of the accelerated logs on special, the accelerated logs are on different disks, on faster disks, makes a huge difference for users. And you just checked a box. And redeployed.
Yeah, that's the beauty of it. You just have to click on the checkbox and it does the rest for you. You don't have to worry about any settings. And our vision with it, basically with Business Critical, is to give this option as default for the customers. In Business Critical tier, we want to make this enabled for everyone. And the best part of it is that it is available at free of cost. So don't have to pay for it. And the performance gains are out of the box for the customers. So it's 2x increase without any additional cost. And there's more. With Azure MySQL, we do all our benchmarking on the community version of MySQL. So if you have MySQL hosted in any environment, in any world, in anywhere in the part of the world, you just have to move to Azure MySQL with minimal application changes. So that no application changes whatsoever, because we take the community version of MySQL and host it on the Azure best environment and give the best performance. And so that makes us that we have no vendor lock-in. So it becomes that you get best performance, you get the best of Azure environment, and you have no vendor lock-in as well. And with business critical and accelerated logs, it's a win-win for everyone.
So it's not twice the price for twice the perf.
Exactly. So that's the main motto for us, to give it out of the box. Once we have a few limitations uplifted, we are going to give it out of the box for everyone in business critical team.
Wow. So let me ask you this. Is there no reason should everyone just click accelerated log? Is there any reason for me not to click the make it faster checkbox?
There's no reason whatsoever.
That's fantastic.
I don't believe it.
This is available now. Of course, you do have a restart during that deployment process that we did see, but you can do that, you know, when you pause your workload, you can do that in an off hours application maintenance moment. If you're using MySQL on Azure right now, there's no reason for you not to go and turn this on and get all the benefits today.
Yes, and that's the point. And with all these features, I don't think we have to sell this. I think this feature sells for itself. That's my point.
I love it. The go faster checkbox and all of these great improvements in this memory optimized and now the business critical service tier for Azure Database for MySQL. Thanks so much for sharing this with me today.
Thank you. Thank you, Scott. It was a great pleasure to be here.
All right. I am learning all about how to run my tier one workloads worry-free on Azure DB for MySQL business critical tier today on Azure Friday.
Hey, thanks for watching this episode of Azure Friday. Now I need you to like it, comment on it, tell your friends, retweet it. Watch more Azure Friday.